Hello everyone, I hope that you can see me now. Please say hi in the chat window if my voice is audible to everyone. Kya aap sabhi mujhe sun pa rahe hain? Are you able to listen to me as well as am I audible to everyone? So we got Pratibha. Hi Pratibha, hi Darpan. Hi Lakshmi. Hi Chinu. Hi Smita. Hi Vijay. Hi Pranita Madhuri Nahid. Hello everyone. Good evening everyone. So in today's session we will be discussing about relations. So in the last class we discussed about the reflexive relation, and in this class we will continue with the relations only. So first of all we will just do a simple revision regarding the reflexive relation, and then we will discuss about the other relation, other type, other properties of relations. Okay, so I hope that all of you have revised the last class, because this class is actually the continuation of the last class. And so right now it's 6 p.m. here. Hi Dev, hi Ashi. So right now it's 6 p.m. here, and there's some chances of rain. So if in any case the network gets disconnected, the video gets disconnected, please assume that it is because of the rain. Otherwise we are continuing the class in the same on the correct time. Okay, so there's 13 people came, so let us wait for 2 to 3 minutes. It's already 6:06. So we will start at 6:10. So just 3 to 4 minutes we will start, and so let's wait for 2 to 3 minutes only for other people to join the session. As soon as everyone joins the session we will start. Okay, so we'll wait for 2 to 3 minutes only. Fine. So if you have, so we'll continue with this previous session only. I mean the topic is from the previous session only. So we'll start in 2 to 3 minutes. Let us wait for other people to join in. I hope that I'm audible to everyone. If there's any issues with the voice, please let me know. But my triad is that my voice should be clear. Okay. Okay, so let us start. So in the previous class, I gave you a brief introduction about relations. So we have seen what are relations, and we have already seen what is a reflexive relation. So I already told you that there are different properties of relation. The first kind of relation is reflexive. The second kind is irreflexive relation. The third one is symmetric relation. Fourth one is antisymmetric. Fifth one is asymmetric. Sixth is transitive. Seventh is equivalence. And the eighth one that we are going to discuss here, that is posets, which is partially ordered sets. And after posets, we are also going to discuss about tosets, which are called as totally ordered set. So we will be having two sessions today. If the weather allows, we will be having two sessions today. So in the first session, we will be discussing about all these kinds of properties of relations. In the second session, we will take some questions, as well as we will also look at lattices. Okay. So Hesse diagram and lattices we will be discussing on the next session. Fine. So just for revision purposes, well, this is the definition of reflexive relation. So we say a relation R on a set A is reflexive if A, A belong to the relation R on every element A belongs to the set A. Now that means if in a relation, if all these diagonal elements are present, then we call that the relation is a reflexive relation. If any one of these diagonal element is missing, then we say that relation is not reflexive. Okay, and in the previous session also we have seen how many reflexive relations are possible. So we have already seen how many reflexive relations are possible. Okay, so we have taken some of these examples. We have seen this also, that if number of elements in the set A is n, then there are 2 raised to power n square minus n unique reflexive relations are possible. So this is 2 raised to power n square minus n. This is something that we have already seen in the previous session. Now we have already seen this. This is example of reflexive relations. For example, is equal to is a reflexive relation, is a subset of is a reflexive relation, divides is a reflexive relation, is greater than or equal to is a reflexive relation, is less than or equal to, the relation is parallel to is reflexive on the set of all lines. Okay, so we have already seen these examples, and then we have already taken some of the questions. For example, this is the truth and false, true and false. So we have seen that reflexive relations are closed under the operation union. The reflexive relations are also closed under the operation intersection, but reflexive relations are not closed under the operation set difference, as well as reflexive relation is also closed under the operation superset, but it is not closed under the operation subset. So we have already seen these questions, these things in the previous class. Now I want all of you to ask, I want all of you to see this and tell me if you have any doubts in this. Do you want me to, do you have any doubts in reflexive relation? Please ask if you have any doubts, and if do you want me to repeat anything in the reflexive relations, please tell me. Otherwise I will start with irreflexive. Okay, so Devendra, you want me to explain the part B of this true and false? So you want me to explain this B option or what? Yes, okay. So see, it says if R1 is a reflexive relation, then every subset of R1 is reflexive. This is false. How this is false? Let us assume that we have a set A which is 1, 2 and 3. These are the values which are present in the set A. Now we have a relation R1 here on A, and let us assume that this relation is reflexive. Reflexive means this relation is having all the diagonal elements. So the diagonal elements are 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. So all the diagonal elements should be present in a relation if the relation has to be reflexive. A part of this, we might be having some extra values. So they are not mandatory but optional, because then only the different relations are possible. So let us assume that we have an extra value which is 1, 2. We have a value 2, 1. We have a value which is 3, 1. So now you can clearly see that this relation R1 is reflexive. And here this option is saying if R1 is reflexive, then every subset of R1 is reflexive. But that is not the case, because if you take a subset of this relation R1, assuming that we have a relation R2 which is having the following values, which are 1, 1, and we have 3, 3, and we have 1, 2, and we have 2, 1, and we have 3, 1. So this is your relation R2. Now you can clearly see that R2 is a subset of the relation R1. R2 is a subset of the relation R1, but R2 is not reflexive. R2 is not reflexive. R1 is reflexive. Why R2 is not reflexive? Because in case of R2, we don't have the pair which is 2, 2. There is one diagonal element is missing. This is the reason why R2 is not reflexive, but R2 is a subset of R1. So here they are saying that every subset of relation R1 will be reflexive, but you can clearly see I have given you an example of a relation which is a subset of R1, and this relation is not reflexive. Okay, is it clear, Dave? Is it clear? Anyone else, do you have any doubts? If you don't have any doubts, please write in the chat window. There are 15 people watching. I need 15 replies. Everyone, if you don't have any doubts, please say continue, and if you have any doubts, please ask in reflexive relations. We will continue with the session. If you don't have any doubts, please write. I need replies from everyone. The difference between a proper subset and a subset is that in case of a subset, we can also have equal values. I mean, equal values are also, can be there in the subset. But in a proper subset, it should be smaller. So I mean to say, when you write a subset, so subset symbol is like this. But when you write a proper subset, it means the symbol is like this. It is just like when you write less than or equal to, or you write less than. In case of less than or equal to, you can also have an equal to value, right? But in case of less than, you can only have a value which is less than but not equal to. So in the case, in the same way, in case of subset, we can also have a set which is having exactly equal values. But in case of proper subset, we cannot have a set which is having exactly equal values. I hope this is clear. So I got replies from Lakshmi, Pratibha, Smita, Madhuri, Chinu, Ashi, Harika, Darpan and Vijay. Okay. So still, Dev, do you have any doubts? So this is the definition of irreflexive relation. We say a relation R on a set A is called irreflexive if and only if every A, A does not belong to the relation for every element A for the set A. I mean to say, a relation will be irreflexive if and only if these diagonal elements are not present. If any one of these diagonal elements will be present, then we say that the relation is not irreflexive. For a relation to be irreflexive, these diagonal element or any of these diagonal element should not exist. Okay, so diagrammatically you can also say that these diagonal elements should not exist. If these diagonal element does not exist, then only we can say the relation is irreflexive. Okay, so let me show you with the help of an example. Let us assume that let me just change the slide first. Yeah, so look at this one first. So let us assume that we have a set A which is having values 1, 2, 3. Now if I say we have a relation R1 on a set A and it is having the values 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 2 and 1, 3. We have second relation which is R2. Its value is 1, 1. We have 2, 2. We have 1, 2. We have 2, 1. We have a relation R3 which is having 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3. We have a relation R4 which is having the values 1, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. So here we have 2, 3 and 3, 2. Then we have a relation R5 which is an empty set, or you can say 5. We have a relation R6 which is having the values 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2 and 3, 3. So assume that we have all these relations. Now look at these relations. So we have a set A which is having 3 elements, which is 1, 2 and 3. Now just answer these questions. Is the relation R1 reflexive? Can you say that the relation R1 is reflexive? Please write in the chat window. Is the relation R1 reflexive? Need replies from everyone. Please write if it is reflexive or not. Yes, so relation R1 here is reflexive. The relation R1 is reflexive. It is yes. Or you can say yes, it is reflexive. Why it is reflexive? Because all the diagonal elements are present. For example, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. All these diagonal elements are present. That is why we can say this relation is reflexive. Can you say that relation R1 is irreflexive? No. The relation R1 is not irreflexive. It is not irreflexive. Why? Because these diagonal elements are present. In irreflexive relation, no diagonal element should be present. Even if any one of the diagonal element will be there, so we can say the relation is not irreflexive. Clear? Now look at R2. Can you say the relation R2 is reflexive? Need answers from everyone. Fatafat jaldi se reply kar dijiye in the chat window. Can you say the relation R2 is reflexive? R2 is not reflexive. So can you say that relation R2 is irreflexive? Can you say the relation R2 is irreflexive? You can clearly see the relation R2 is also not irreflexive. It is not irreflexive. See, why the relation R2 is not reflexive? Because it is not having the element 3, 3. Why the relation R2 is irreflexive? Because it is having the element 1, 1 and 2, 2. I mean to say, in Hindi I am again explaining, reflexive relations ke andar सभी के सभी डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स होने चाहिए, जैसे कि यहाँ पर 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, सभी डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स रिफ्लेक्सिव रिलेशन में होने चाहिए. लेकिन इररिफ्लेक्सिव रिलेशन के अंदर कोई भी डायगोनल एलिमेंट नहीं होना चाहिए. इवन इफ वन डायगोनल एलिमेंट एग्जिस्ट देन द रिलेशन विल नॉट बी इररिफ्लेक्सिव. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी जो रिलेशन आर टू है ना तो वो रिफ्लेक्सिव है और ना ही इररिफ्लेक्सिव. सो रिलेशन आर टू इज नाइदर रिफ्लेक्सिव नॉर इररिफ्लेक्सिव. So you can clearly see that every opposite relation, if a relation is reflexive, then its opposite is not irreflexive. These are two different categories. So reflexive means all the diagonal elements should be present. Irreflexive means none of the diagonal elements should be present. Even if one diagonal element will be there, then relation will not be irreflexive. Now you can see the relation R3 here. So R3 is not reflexive. Why it is not reflexive? Because all the diagonal elements are not present. Here 1, 1 is there, but 2, 2 is not there, and 3, 3 is not there. But R3 is also not irreflexive. Why? Because in case of R3, 1, 1 is present. So because of this reason, R3 is not irreflexive. Now look at the relation R4. So R4 is not reflexive. R4 reflexive nahi hai. So why? Because all the diagonal elements are not present, but R4 is irreflexive because you can clearly see even one single diagonal element is not present. Now you can clearly see R5. R5 is not reflexive. R5 is not reflexive as well as R5 is irreflexive. R5 is not reflexive, but R5 is irreflexive. In the same way, look at R6. So in case of R6, all the elements are present. 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3. So because all the diagonal elements are already present, so you can clearly see that R6 is reflexive, but R6 is not irreflexive. Okay. Is it clear to everyone? Do you have any doubts? Is this clear to everyone? Please ask if you have any doubts. So whenever you don't have any doubts, just write no doubts. Okay? So that will be better. Good. So you need explanation for R5. So Samitha, you can see in case of R5, R5 is empty. I mean, no elements are present in R5. So you can clearly see if all the diagonal elements are present, then only it can be reflexive. So because there is no element, that is why it is not reflexive. And there is no diagonal elements are present. So the only condition for irreflexive is diagonal elements should not be there. So because there is no diagonal element is there, that is why R5 is irreflexive. Is it clear? Is it clear, Samitha? Is it clear with everyone? Good. So what is the relationship between reflexive and irreflexive? Can you tell me the relationship between reflexive and irreflexive? Okay, before that, just answer this question. So answer this question. What are the number of irreflexive relations possible? If we have a set A with n elements, then what are the number of irreflexive relations possible? What are the number of irreflexive relations possible? On a set A with n elements, so let us assume we have a set A with total of n elements, then A cross A will be having total of n square elements. Now I am asking, what are the number of irreflexive relations are possible over A cross A? So need answers from everyone. Those who can find out the answer, please write. And those who are having, take your time. I am giving you time to find out the answer. So there is no hurry. So by the way, some students already know the answer. I want to know, how do you know the answer? Have you studied this topic before? Kya aap is topic ko pehle padh chuke hain? So take your time. I need answers from everyone. So we have, I'll give you 2 to 3 minutes. Okay. So let us look at this one. So correct answer here is, what is the correct answer? 2 raised to power n square minus n. So let us say that we have a set A which is having a total of n elements. The elements are 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to so on till n. Therefore A cross A will be having the elements which are 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4 up to so on 1, n, then 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3 up to so on 2, n. In the same way, n, 1, n, 2, n, 3 up to so on n, n. Therefore, you can clearly see that your A cross A, this cross product, will be having a total of n square elements. So A cross A will be having total of n square elements. Now, out of all these n square elements, if a relation has to be irreflexive, that means none of these diagonal elements should be present. So you can clearly see how many diagonal elements will be there. So there are total of n diagonal elements will be there. So there are total of n diagonal elements. For relation to be irreflexive, none of these diagonal elements should be present. If any one of these diagonal elements is present, then we say that relation is not irreflexive. Okay, so none of these diagonal elements should be present. So you can clearly see, for these diagonal elements, we don't have a choice. We cannot include them in a relation. But for the other elements, so how many number of elements are left after removing these diagonal elements? They are n square minus n elements are left. Elements are non-diagonal elements. So n square minus n elements are non-diagonal elements. And for every element, we have a choice. Either you want to include this element in the relation, or you do not want to include this element. Either you want to include this element in the relation, or you do not want to include. Either you want to include this element in the relation, or you do not want to include. So you can clearly see, for all these n square minus n element, for every element we have two choices. Either you want to include them, or you do not want to include them. So you can clearly see that we have 2 raised to power n square minus n choices. For each of these elements, we have these many choices. So with these choices, how many number of relations are possible? How many different irreflexive relations are possible? These are 2 raised to power n square minus n unique irreflexive relations are possible. So none of these diagonal elements should be present, that is for sure. But for all the non-diagonal elements, we don't have a choice. Is it clear? None of these diagonal elements should be present. So for these diagonal elements, we don't have a choice. But for all the non-diagonal elements, we have choices. That is whether they should be present or they should not be present. Is it clear? Do any one of you have any doubts? So next is, what is the relationship between reflexive and irreflexive relations? So we can represent this. So we can represent this with the help of a diagram. So you can clearly see that if this is representing the universal set, so universal set is a set of all relations that are possible. So how many relations are possible? We already know there are 2 raised to power n square relations are possible over a set A with n elements. So over a set A with n elements, there are 2 raised to power n square elements are possible. Now let us assume this is the set of relations which are reflexive. This is a set of relations which are reflexive. So you can say any relation, if it is reflexive, it cannot be irreflexive. So basically, these set of relations which are reflexive and the set of relations which are irreflexive, they are disjoint set. They are disjoint set, because if a relation is reflexive, it cannot be irreflexive. If a relation is irreflexive, it cannot be reflexive. So we clearly know that their sets are disjoint sets because they do not have any element or any relation in common. They cannot have anything in common. Now we already know that there are 2 raised to power n square minus n reflexive relations are possible. At the same time, we have 2 raised to power n square minus n irreflexive relations are possible. So you can easily calculate how many number of relations are present which are neither reflexive nor irreflexive. So you can see number of relations which are neither reflexive nor irreflexive. How many relations are there? That is 2 raised to power n square minus 2 raised to power n square minus n minus 2 raised to power n square minus n. I mean, I'm going to subtract this one and this one from this complete set. So this is going to be how much? 2 raised to power n square minus 2 raised to power n square minus n plus 1. So you can easily calculate this value. From this value, you can take n square as common and you can easily calculate this value. So by this value, you can easily find out how many number of relations are possible which are neither reflexive nor irreflexive. Okay, so if I ask you how many number of relations which are reflexive as well as irreflexive, they are zero because they do not have anything in common. So we cannot have any relation which is reflexive as well as irreflexive. And these are the number of relations which are neither reflexive nor irreflexive. These are the number of relations which are reflexive and these are the number of relations which are irreflexive. Okay, any doubts? Reflexive and irreflexive portions are equal of an element, sir. Yes, so number of reflexive as well as irreflexive relations are equal. Any doubts in this? If you don't have any doubt, please write no doubts in the chat window. If you have any doubt, please ask. So there are 15 people are watching. I need replies from everyone. Do you have any doubts? Good. So I hope this much is good and you understood well. So now look at some of the examples of irreflexive relations. So these are the examples of irreflexive relations. So Devendra, any relation, if the relation is reflexive, then it cannot be irreflexive. So I guess that was clear. If a relation is reflexive, it cannot be irreflexive. Okay. So I think I already explained it well. So you can see the example of irreflexive relations, for example, is not equal to. So if we have a set A, which is having elements which are 1, 2, 3, 4, up to so on, let us suppose N. And if the relation is R1 is equal to A comma B such that A is not equal to B and A comma B belong to the set A. So then we say that relation is not irreflexive. So you can clearly make the set for this one. Okay, you can clearly see what are the elements that will represent in this relation. In the same way, is co-prime 2. So co-prime, this is also irreflexive. So co-prime is these A and B, they do not have any common divisor apart of one. So they do not have any other common divisor. So that is how we can say co-prime. Next is a proper subset of. So proper subset, that is if the we have a relation where we can have the set A and B such that A is a proper subset of B. So that is also irreflexive. Is greater than. Greater than is also irreflexive, is less than is also irreflexive. So these are also written like this. So these are the examples of the relations which are irreflexive. Okay. I hope it is clear. I don't think so there is any doubt. Now I want all of you to answer these questions. So again, these are the questions that every subset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive. Every superset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive. If R1 and R2 are irreflexive, the intersection will be irreflexive, their union will be irreflexive, their subtraction is irreflexive, closed under union, closed under intersection, closed under difference. I want all of you to answer these questions, state true and false. You have 2 minutes, take your time. And I want all of you to answer your write your answers in one line only. So option number 1 se lekar 8 tak aapne sabhi answer ek hi line mein likhe instead of doing separate comment for every line, because that makes it difficult for me to read. So just write your answers in one line, true and false. You have 2 minutes, I'm giving you 2 minutes, okay? So I got few answers here. All are true, that is not correct. All are not true. So let me show you some examples here. Assuming that we have a set A which is having the values 1, 2, 3. Now every subset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive, that is true. The first one is true. If you take any irreflexive relation, that means it is not having any of the diagonal elements. So that is why it is irreflexive. If you take a subset, obviously none of the diagonal elements will be there in the subset. That is why it will be true for every diagonal element. I don't think so. There's so much explanation is required for this. Now look at the second one. Every superset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive. This is false. Why? Let us take, we have a relation R1 which is having the values 1, 2, 1, 1, 3 and 3, 1. So you can clearly see that R1 is irreflexive. But if you take a superset of R1, let us assume which is R2. So R2 is having the values 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. So you can clearly see that R2 is a superset of R1, or you can say R1 is a subset of R2. Now you can say that R2 is not irreflexive. Why it is not irreflexive? Because 1, 1 is present. Because of the 1, 1, that is why it is not irreflexive. So you can see every superset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive. This is false. Next, if R1 is irreflexive and R2 is also irreflexive, then R1 intersection R2 is irreflexive. That is also true. I don't think so there is any doubt. If R1 is irreflexive and R2 is also irreflexive, then their union is also irreflexive. This is also true. Next, R1 and R2 are irreflexive, then R1 minus R2 will be irreflexive. That is also true. The set of all irreflexive relations are closed under the operation union. So this is also true. The set of all irreflexive relations are closed under the operation intersection. That is also true. The set of all irreflexive relations are closed under the operation difference. That is also true. I hope this is clear. Okay. So only the second one is false. Others are true. Now tell me, do you need any explanation for any one of them? If you need any explanation, please tell me. The superset of irreflexive relation is irreflexive. Yes. The superset of irreflexive relation is not irreflexive. It cannot, it is not necessary that it is irreflexive. Okay. So you need explanation for 6, 7 and 8. So 6 is saying the set of irreflexive relations are closed under union. That means what is a closure operation is, if you take a set and this entire set is a set of irreflexive relation, and if you take any two relations from this, let us assume the relation R1, let us assume the relation R2. So R1 is irreflexive because it is not having any of the diagonal elements. R2 is also irreflexive because it is not having any of the diagonal elements. Both in R1 and R2 are not having any of the diagonal elements. So even if you take the union of R1 and R2, you will not get a set which is having diagonal element, because they are already not having any diagonal elements, right? So agar inka aap union bhi denge, tab bhi aapko union mein bhi koi bhi diagonal element nahi milega, because R1 and R2 ke andar hai hi nahi diagonal elements. In the same way, the set of all irreflexive relations are closed under the operation intersection. Even if you take an intersection of R1 and R2, you will not find any diagonal elements. That is why the intersection will also be irreflexive. Okay, is it correct? Now again write, if you have any doubt in any one of these questions. Everyone please ask if you have any doubts. Do you want me to explain any of these options again? Superset मतलब बड़ा set. I mean to say, अगर एक set दूसरे का subset है, जैसे कि यहाँ पर R1 is a subset of R2, In the same way, R2 is a superset of R1. That is superset. R1 is a subset of R2 and R2 is a subset of superset of R1. Superset means uska ek extra kuch hona chahiye. It is just like opposite of subset. Clear? Any other doubt? Do anyone of you have any other doubt? Should I move on to the next relation? Please write, if you don't have any doubt, please write no doubts in the chat window so that I can move on to the next one. Please write quickly and fast. Good. So look at the next one. This is symmetric relations. Just read the definition once for symmetric relations. So a relation R. So relation R on a set A is called symmetric if B, A belong to the relation R whenever A, B belong to the relation R for all A, B belong to the set A. And a relation R on a set A such that for all A, B belong to A, if A, B belong to R and B, A belong to R, then A, B, A should be equal to B is called as anti-symmetric. Okay, let me explain you both symmetric as well as anti-symmetric here. So first, let me give an example for both of them. Let us assume that we have a set A which is having the elements 1, 2, 3. These are the elements 1, 2 and 3. Fine. Let me explain symmetric first. So we have a set A which is having the elements 1, 2, 3. And A cross A will be having 1, 1. 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1, 3, 2, and 3, 3. So this is A cross A. Now a relation is said to be symmetric if A, B belong to the relation, then B, A should also belong. Okay. So again I'm writing a relation is said to be symmetric if A comma B belongs to the relation, then B comma A should also belong to the relation. I mean to say, if 1 comma 2 is there, then 2 comma 1 should also be there. If 1 comma 3 is there, then 3 comma 1 should also be there. So then we say that the relation is symmetric. So you can clearly see this relation R1 is symmetric because 1, 2 is there, therefore 2, 1 is there. 1, 3 is there, therefore 3, 1 is there. So you can see this relation R1 is symmetric. This is symmetric. Correct? If you take the relation R2, which is having the elements 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, and here we have 2, 2. So this relation is also symmetric. Why? Because 1 comma 1 is there, so just like here 1 comma 2 is there, therefore 2 comma 1 is there. So even if you reverse 1 comma 1, you will always get 1 comma 1, which is already present. So 1 comma 1 can be there, 2 comma 2 can be there. Here you can see 1 comma 2 is there, therefore 2 comma 1 is also there. So if element AB is there, therefore BA is also there. So here AB is 1 1, so BA will also be 1 1. And this is also, this is representing a set. A set cannot be having duplicate values. So the duplicate value, so for 1, 1, the symmetric value is also 1, 1. Therefore, 1, 1 is already present. Okay. So again, I'm explaining. Agar A, B hai, to B, A, B hona chahiye. Ab yahan par, A, B yahan par 1, 1 hai. To B, A, B 1, 1 hoga. So obviously, that is already present. Correct? So iske liye hamare paas, iske opposite value bhi yahan par already present hai. If you take the relation R3, assuming the values are 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 1. So you can see the relation R3 is not symmetric. Why? Because 1, 2 is there, so 2, 1 is not there. 1,3 is there, but 3,1 is not there. That is why this relation R3 is not symmetric. If you take the relation R4, which is 1,1, 2,2, 3,3. So we can clearly see the relation R4 is symmetric. Why? Because if you take 1,1, if you take opposite of this, this is AB, even if you take BA, that will also be 1,1. So this relation R4 is also symmetric. If you take the relation R5, which is having the values 1,2, 2,1, 1,3, 3,1, 1,1, 2,2, and 2,3. So this relation R5 is not symmetric. Why? Because this is fine. Ek pair yahan par aa gaya. This pair is already present. This pair is also already present. So 1,1 is also fine. This is also fine. But this is not fine. Because 2,3 is there. Therefore 3,2 should also be there. Okay. So now did you understood what is symmetric relations? Do any one of you have any doubts about what is symmetric relation? Just look at this and tell me if you have any doubts. So we have these relations, which is R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 and R6. Tell me which of these relations are symmetric, which of these relations are reflexive, which of these relations are irreflexive. So for all these relations, tell me which of these relations are symmetric, which of these relations are reflexive, as well as which of these relations are irreflexive. So let us see. So we have relation R1, and here the set A is having the elements 1,2,3,4. So we have the relation R1. So let us see if all the diagonal elements are present. We have 1,1, 2,2, 4,4, but 3,3 is not there. Therefore, this relation is not reflexive. Okay. Now, is it irreflexive? It is not irreflexive. Why? Because some of the diagonal elements are present. Is it symmetric? 1,1 is there, that is fine. 1,2 is there, therefore 2,1 is also there. Therefore, that is also good. 2,2 is there, that is fine. 3,4 is there, so 4,3 should also be there. If 4,1 is there, so 1,4 should also be there. Therefore, this relation is also not symmetric. It is also not symmetric. So first relation is neither reflexive nor irreflexive. Third, not even symmetric. Second, in the second R2, the second relation R2 is not reflexive because 1,1 is there, but 2,2, 3,3 and 4,4 is not there. Therefore, you can see R2 is not reflexive. R2 is also not irreflexive because 1,1 is there, one diagonal element is present. R2 is symmetric. Why? 1,1 is fine, 1,2 is there, then 2,1 is also there. Therefore, R2 is symmetric. Look at the relation R3. So we have 1,1, we have 2,2, we have 3,3, we have 4,4. Therefore, all the diagonal elements are present. Hence, you can say this relation is reflexive. So R3 is reflexive. Next, here you can say, can you see this relation is irreflexive? So because it is reflexive, so obviously it cannot be irreflexive. It is not irreflexive. Is it symmetric? So 1,1 is there, 1,2 is there, therefore 2,1 is there. 1,4 is there, therefore 4,1 is also there. 2,2 is there, 3,3 is there, 4,4 is there. Therefore this relation is also symmetric. So this relation is reflexive as well as symmetric. Third, R4. So 2,1 is there, right? So first of all, is it reflexive? It is not reflexive because none of the diagonal elements are present. So it is not reflexive. Is it irreflexive? Yes, it is irreflexive because none of the diagonal elements are present. Therefore, it is irreflexive. Is it symmetric? So 2,1 is there, but 1,2 is not there. 3,1 is there, but 1,3 is not there. 3,2 is there, but 2,3 is not there. So you can see it is not even symmetric. Look at next one, R5. So 1,1 is there, 1,2, So first of all, look at if it is reflexive. So 1,1 is there, 2,2 is there, 3,3 is there, 4,4 is there. Therefore, you can see this is reflexive. Is it irreflexive? No, it is not irreflexive. Is it symmetric? So 1,1 is fine. 1,2 is there, but 2,1 is not there. 1,3 is there, but 3,1 is not there. 1,4 is there, but 4,1 is not there. Therefore, it is not even symmetric. Now look at the next one, R6. So here 3,4 is there. So this relation is not reflexive. This relation is, yes, it is irreflexive, but this relation is not symmetric because 3,4 is there, but 4,3 is not there. Okay. Now if I add something else, let us suppose we have a relation R7, which is 5. That means R7 is not having any element. Now you can see R7 is not reflexive, but it is irreflexive as well as it is also symmetric. Let me take more examples. Let us assume we have a relation R8, which is having the values 1,2, 2,1, 1,3, 3,1, 2,3, 3,2. So you can clearly see this relation is not reflexive, but this relation is irreflexive as well as this relation is also symmetric. So this relation is also symmetric. R8 is reflexive as well as symmetric. Okay, so irreflexive as well as symmetric. Now tell me, do you have any doubts in any one of them? Please have a look at them and tell me if you have any doubts. If you have, you don't have. So we are asking Pradiva, why R7 is symmetric? See, in case of symmetric, the only condition is that if A comma B is there, then B comma A is also not there. It is not saying if no element exists. Symmetric is only saying if there exists an element A comma B, then B comma A should also be there. So a relation can be empty. There is no issues whatsoever. Okay. So R7 can be symmetric. Clear? So I'm saying if a set A is having a total of n elements, then how many relations are possible which are symmetric? How many relations are possible which are symmetric? Kitne relations possible hain jo ki symmetric honge? So take time, everyone, please take time, solve this question. How many relations are possible which are symmetric? Because some of the people already studied this topic, hence I should not look at their solutions, but I should take everyone. So take your time, I am not in hurry. Tell me how many relations are possible which are symmetric. Okay, so I got only 6 replies. So I got replies from Ashi, Vijay, Devendra, Chinu, Smita and Pratibha. Let me explain you how many relations are possible which are symmetric. Let us assume that we have a set A which is having the values 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we can write A cross A in this manner, which are 1,1, 2,2, 3,3, 4,4. A part of this, we can have 1,2, 2,1, 1,3, 3,1, 1,4, 4,1, 2,3, 3,2, 2,4, 4,2, 3,4, 4,3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So all the 16 values are present. Okay. Now for a relation to be symmetric, these elements should come in a pair. So if 1,2 is there, then 2,1 will be there. If 1,3 is there, then 3,1 should also be there. If 1,4 is there, then 4,1 should also be there. If 2,3 is there, therefore 3,2 is also should also be there. If 2,4 is there, so 4,2 should also be there. And 3,4, then 4,3 should also be there. Therefore you can clearly see whenever a non-diagonal element is coming, so it should come with its pair. Then only we can say the relation is symmetric, otherwise the relation is not symmetric. So non-diagonal element should always come in the pair. So these diagonal elements, they have two choices. Every element is having two choices. this element may be there, may not be there. So it is having two choices. This element is also having two choices. This element is also having two choices. This element is also having two choices. So every diagonal element is having two choices. But the non-diagonal elements here, both these elements have two choices combined because they cannot be calculated separately, right? These two elements have only two choices. That is, either both will be present or both will not be present. These elements have two choices. Either both of them will be present or they should not be present. They have two choices. Either both of them should be present or they are not there. They have two choices. Either both of them should be present or they are not there. They have two choices. Either both of them are present or they are not there. So total, how many choices we have? Multiply them. So it is 2 into 2 into 2. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So here 2 raised to power 10 choices are there, which is with this set, there are 1024 relations are possible which are symmetric. How many relations are possible? 1024, which is 2 raised to power 10. But if I say the set A is having a total of n element, or you can say cardinality of A is having total of n element. So for all the diagonal elements, for all diagonal elements, we have only two choice. Either they will be there, then they will not be there. So yani ki sabhi diagonal elements ke liye hamare paas individual choices rahenge. So how many diagonal elements are there? There are total of n diagonal elements. So they will be having 2 raised to power n choices. Okay. So you can see there are n diagonal elements are present, and there are n square minus n non-diagonal elements are present. So I've already explained to you how it is n square minus n. Now if you take this non-diagonal element and if you divide these non-diagonal elements in a pair, so there are n square minus n divided by 2 paired non-diagonal elements are present. Pairs of non-diagonal elements. So there are these many pairs are present. So for example, here you can see how many pairs are there. How many diagonal elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. And how many non-diagonal elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there are 6 pairs of non-diagonal element. In the same way, if the cardinality of set A is n, so there are n square minus n divided by 2 pairs of non-diagonal element. Therefore, for all non-diagonal elements, we have 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2 choices are there. Therefore, you can see how many number of symmetric relations, possible. They will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. So these many relations are possible which are symmetric. So which is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Okay. So I hope it is clear. Please ask if you have any doubts. So again, let me explain this properly again. Some of you might not have understood. So I've taken a small example with a set A, which is having a total of 4 elements. Okay. So let me also explain this in Hindi for the students who could not understand. Jaise ki humne ek example liya, jisme ek set A hai, uske andar aapke paas 4 elements hai. There are 4 elements in the set A. Now we found out what is A cross A. So A cross A will be having a total of 16 elements. But if you try to see, in 16 elements ke andar, there are 4 diagonal elements are present and there are 12 non-diagonal elements are present. Ab jo bhi non-diagonal elements hamare paas present honge, they should come in a pair. For example, 1,2 is there, then 2,1 should also be there. If 1,3 is there, therefore 3,1 should also be there. So all these non-diagonal elements should always come in a pair. So for every pair, we have two choice that whether this entire pair is there or this entire pair is not there. So yahan par aapke paas total 6 pairs the, to hamare paas 2 raised power 6 choices thi in 6 pairs ke liye. Aur aapke paas 4 non-diagonal elements the, to unke liye hamare paas 2 raised power 4 choices thi. To total aapke paas 2 raised power 10 choices banegi. So in this case, you have 1024, or you can say 2 raised power 10 symmetric relations are possible. Lekin, agar main isko extend karta hun, if I try to extend it, let us assume we have a set A which is having a total of n elements. Agar aapke paas n elements hain, to us case mein aapke paas n diagonal elements honge aur n square minus n non-diagonal elements honge. अब इन सभी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स को मुझे पेयर के अंदर डिवाइड करना है, सो विल बी हैविंग एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई टू पेयर्स, और कैसे एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई टू पेयर्स ऑफ नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट. सो फॉर ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स वी हैव टू पावर एन चॉइसेस, बिकॉज फॉर एवरी एलिमेंट वी हैव टू चॉइस. फॉर ऑल द नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट फॉर एवरी पेयर वी हैव टू चॉइसेस, सो दैट मीन्स टू पावर एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई टू चॉइसेस. सो इफ यू सी नंबर ऑफ सिमेट्रिक रेशियोज, दैट इज फॉर दीज चॉइसेस मल्टीप्लाइड बाई दीज चॉइसेस, विच इज 2 to the power n multiplied by 2 square n square minus n divided by 2 choices. So you can easily add them up and you can find out what is the number of symmetric relations are possible. Okay. Is there any doubt? I hope it is clear. If it is clear, please write clear in the chat window. If any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, I'll take the next. So try to answer this question. What are the number of relations which are both reflexive as well as symmetric? How many relations are possible which are reflexive as well as symmetric? How many relations are possible which are reflexive as well as symmetric? Try to answer this question. Take your time, I'm not in hurry. You have 5 minutes to tell me how many relations are possible which are reflexive. I mean, you have to tell these values. How many relations are possible which are reflexive as well as symmetric? Then how many relations are possible which are symmetric but not reflexive? How many relations are possible which are reflexive but not symmetric? And then how many relations are possible which are neither symmetric nor reflexive? So this is on a set A with n elements. Answer all these questions. ऐसे कितने relation होंगे जो कि symmetric और reflexive दोनों हैं? ऐसे कितने relation हैं जो कि symmetric है लेकिन reflexive नहीं है? ऐसे कितने रिलेशन हैं जो कि रिफ्लेक्सिव हैं लेकिन सिमेट्रिक नहीं है? और ऐसे कितने रिलेशन हैं जो कि ना कि रिफ्लेक्सिव है और ना ही सिमेट्रिक है? आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस. यू हैव 5 मिनट्स. सो आफ्टर 5 मिनट्स आई विल आंसर, आई विल गिव द आंसर. इन 5 मिनट्स प्लीज राइट योर आंसर्स इन द चैट विंडो. एनी आंसर्स? आई हैव नॉट रिसीव्ड एनी आंसर टिल नाउ. अब तक मुझे किसी का आंसर नहीं आया है. नो देवेंद्र, यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेंबर ऑल दीज रिजल्ट्स. With some practice, you will be able to solve it. You will be able to derive it. There are 16 people are watching. I'm getting answers from only 2 to 3 people. Baki sabhi students, please, everyone please reply. Even if you get the answer, that is also fine. Even if you don't get the answer, you can write at least so that I know that you are trying. Yes, these kind of questions are asked in objectives. Okay, fine. So reflexive as well as symmetric. So I've given you some of the answers before. We know what are the number of relations. Number of relations. Fine. So we already know that number of relations which are reflexive. Number of relations which are reflexive. We have already calculated this value. And this value is 2 raised to power n square minus n. We already know total number of relations possible. Total number of relations possible. That is 2 raised to power n square. So this entire universal set, this is basically 2 raised to power n square. The set of which is number of reflexive relation, there is 2 raised to power n square minus n. And number of relations which are symmetric, we have already calculated it. So number of symmetric relations, this is basically, we have already calculated it, 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. So we know it is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Okay. Now, first of all, let us find out how many relations are there which are symmetric as well as reflexive. So that is number of relations which are symmetric as well as reflexive. Number of relations which are symmetric as well as reflexive. So for a relation to be symmetric, तो एक बार मैं एग्जांपल आपको देता हूँ, अगर कोई रिलेशन है वो अगर सिमेट्रिक होगा, इफ़ रिलेशन हैज़ टू बी सिमेट्रिक देन ऑल द नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट दे शुड कम इन अ पेयर, एंड इफ अ रिलेशन हैज़ टू बी रिफ्लेक्सिव देन ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट शुड बी देयर. सो इफ आई एम आस्किंग अबाउट द रिफ्लेक्सिव एज वेल एज सिमेट्रिक, सो इन दिस केस ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स शुड बी देयर, डेफिनेटली दे डू नॉट हैव अ चॉइस. सो फॉर ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स वी डू नॉट हैव अ चॉइस, बट फॉर ऑल द नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट इफ इट हैज़ टू बी सिमेट्रिक देन दे शुड कम इन अ पेयर, एंड इफ इट हैज़ टू बी रिफ्लेक्सिव देन डजंट मैटर वेदर दे कम और नॉट, दैट इज नॉट एन इश्यू. सो सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव, सो इट विल बी 2^(n^2) - (n)/2. So how we got this value? Let me write it properly. So this will be 1 × 2^(n^2) - (n)/2. So ये 1 किसके लिए आया? 1 is for diagonal elements. Because अगर relation को reflexive होना है, if the relation has to be reflexive, then all the diagonal elements should be there. सो अगर किसी रिलेशन को रिफ्लेक्सिव होना है तो सभी डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स होने ही होने चाहिए, सो दे डू नॉट हैव अ चॉइस, करेक्ट. एंड अगर नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट है तो रिफ्लेक्सिव डजंट रियली केयर अबाउट नॉन डायगोनल, इसके लिए कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता रिफ्लेक्सिव के लिए, नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट हो या ना हो रिफ्लेक्सिव से डजंट मैटर. रिफ्लेक्सिव की सिर्फ यही कंडीशन है कि डायगोनल एलिमेंट सारे होने चाहिए, तो जितने भी डायगोनल एलिमेंट है उनके लिए हमारे पास कोई भी चॉइस नहीं है. लेकिन सिमेट्रिक बोलता है कि डायगोनल एलिमेंट हो या ना हो उससे ज़्यादा फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा, बिकॉज अगर वो होंगे तब भी सिमेट्रिक रहेगा, नहीं होगा तब भी सिमेट्रिक रहेगा. लेकिन सिमेट्रिक की कंडीशन ये है कि जितने भी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स हैं वो सभी पेयर में आना चाहिए, यानी कि अगर 1, 2 है तो 2, 1 भी होना चाहिए. सो इफ 1, 2 इज प्रेजेंट देयरफॉर 2, 1 शुड ऑल्सो बी प्रेजेंट. सो फॉर सिमेट्रिक जितने भी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट है, कितने नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट है हमारे पास? n^2 - n. तो कितने पेयर्स हो गए? दैट इज n^2 - n/2. और हर एक नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट के पास आपकी दो चॉइस है, हर एक पेयर के पास दो चॉइस है, तो यहाँ पर आएगा 2^(n^2 - n)/2. सो रफली यू कैन से द नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव दे आर 2^(n^2 - n)/2. देयरफॉर वी ऑल नो दिस वैल्यू, सो दिस वैल्यू विल बी 2^(n^2 - n)/2. सो नाउ वी ऑलरेडी नो हाउ मेनी रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल विच आर सिमेट्रिक, हाउ मेनी रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव, हाउ मेनी रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव, एंड हाउ मेनी टोटल नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज हाउ मेनी रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव और सिमेट्रिक. सो कितने ऐसे रिलेशन हैं जो कि रिफ्लेक्सिव या फिर सिमेट्रिक होंगे, रिफ्लेक्सिव और सिमेट्रिक, दैट मीन्स इन दोनों का यूनियन. तो यूनियन में क्या होगा? सो दैट इज इक्वल टू नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक प्लस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव माइनस द वैल्यूज जो हम दो बार कैलकुलेट कर चुके हैं, दैट इज नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव. सो दिस वैल्यू वी हैव ऑलरेडी कैलकुलेटेड. सो बेसिकली दिस इज फ्रॉम द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंक्लूजन एंड एक्सक्लूजन. तो इन प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंक्लूजन एंड एक्सक्लूजन की वजह से हमने इसको ऐसा यूज़ किया है. तो नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक दे विल बी 2^(n^2) - (n)/2. नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव दैट इज 2^(n^2) - (n) माइनस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव दैट इज 2^(n^2) - (n)/2. सो दीज आर द रिलेशंस, दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक और रिफ्लेक्सिव. ओके, नेक्स्ट नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर नाइदर सिमेट्रिक नॉर रिफ्लेक्सिव. नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर नाइदर सिमेट्रिक नॉर रिफ्लेक्सिव यानी कि इस पूरे का कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो दिस इज इक्वल टू द यूनिवर्सल सेट विच इज 2^(n^2) - (n)/2 माइनस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक और रिफ्लेक्सिव. सो दिस इज हाउ यू कैन फाइंड आउट ऑल दिस वैल्यूज. इज इट क्लियर विद एवरीवन? प्लीज आस्क इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स, लुक एट देम, इफ इट इज क्लियर टेल मी. अगर इसमें किसी पोर्शन में कोई डाउट है तो फिर से पूछिए, मैं पूरे पोर्शन को दोबारा से एक्सप्लेन कर सकता हूँ. आई डोंट हैव एनी इश्यूज. एनी अदर डाउट विद एनीवन? देखो ये सभी जो है आई हैव नॉट रिटन देम इन पीपीटीज, तो आप अपनी नोटबुक पे बना के इसको ज़रूर लिखिएगा, बिकॉज इफ़ यू डोंट राइट इन योर नोटबुक देन यू हैव टू वॉच दिस वीडियो अगेन. तो ये सभी मैंने पीपीटीज प्रेजेंटेशन में नहीं लिखा है, बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू अंडरस्टैंड कि हमने कैसे निकाला, एंड आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू राइट इट इन योर प्रेजेंटेशन पीपीटीज. ओके, So 17 people are watching. मुझे सिर्फ 4 से 5 replies मिले हैं. Other, I have not received reply from other people. अगर आप live नहीं देख पा रहे हैं, if you are not able to see the stream live, तो आपके पास जहाँ पर वीडियो के म्यूट करने का बटन होता है, वहाँ पर एक लाइव का बटन भी होता है. जस्ट चेक वो जो लाइव का बटन है वो रेड है या नहीं है. इफ़ दैट बटन लाइक लाइव बटन इज़ नॉट लाइव रेड, दैट मीन्स आप लाइव नहीं देख रहे हैं, यू आर बिहाइंड. आप वीडियो को थोड़ा सा यू आर बिहाइंड करंटली. तो इफ़ कई बार ऐसा होता है विद बिकॉज ऑफ योर नेटवर्क इशू, समटाइम्स यू आर नॉट एक्चुअली वॉचिंग द वीडियो लाइव. आप उसकी आप कुछ टाइम पीछे रह जाते हैं. तो प्लीज़ चेक दैट आउट. फाइन. सो देवेंद्र, विच पार्ट डू यू वॉन्ट मी टू एक्सप्लेन? कैन यू राइट अगेन विच पार्ट यू वॉन्ट मी टू एक्सप्लेन? टू एंड थ्री मीन्स, आई डोंट नो वट डू यू मीन बाई टू एंड थ्री. प्लीज राइट इन सेंटेंस. Pranita, one for diagonal element is because if the reflection has to be reflexive, that means it doesn't have any choice for the diagonal element. वो सभी के सभी diagonal elements होने चाहिए. If a relation has to be reflexive, then all the diagonal elements, they should be there. So they do not have a choice. लेकिन non-diagonal element symmetry के केस में उनके पास pairs में choice है. Okay? Okay, symmetric union reflexive. So basically, देखो what happens is symmetric union reflexive में जब आप check करेंगे तो ये पूरा symmetric है और ये पूरा रिफ्लेक्सिव है. तो बेसिकली जब आप सब दोनों का यूनियन लेते हैं तो यहाँ पर हम लोग इस पोर्शन को दो बार काउंट कर लेते हैं. अगर आप करेंगे यहाँ पर नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक, तो यानी कि आपने इस पूरे एरिया को ऐड किया, प्लस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव, यानी कि इस पूरे एरिया को आपने ऐड किया. तो ये जो कॉमन वाला एरिया है, आपने इस एरिया को दो बार ऐड किया है. दैट इज़ वाई इफ़ यू डू यूनियन, तो उस केस में हमें इस कॉमन, बिकॉज हमने इसको दो बार ऐड किया, इसलिए हम इसको एक बार सब्ट्रैक्ट भी करेंगे. ओके, सो दिस इज योर प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंक्लूजन एंड एक्सक्लूजन. दैट इज वाई इन केस ऑफ सिमेट्रिक यूनियन रिफ्लेक्सिव, वी हैव सब्ट्रैक्टेड दिस वैल्यू एंड वी हैव एडेड दीज वैल्यूज. ओके, क्लियर? एनी अदर डाउट? देखो, जब आप यहाँ पर यूनियन को करते हैं, सो यूनियन जब हम करेंगे तो इसका मतलब है कि हमें इस पूरे एरिया को निकालना है. इन केस ऑफ यूनियन वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट दिस एरिया, दिस एंटायर एरिया, दिस इज यूनियन. ओके, सो दिस एंटायर एरिया इज़ यूनियन. सो रिमेंबर, यू कैन क्लियरली सी कि मैंने इस पूरे एरिया को बोला है यहाँ पर. सो इफ़ यू एड नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक प्लस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर रिफ्लेक्सिव, तो नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक दे आर दिस मच, नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक दे आर दिस मच. सो दिस एरिया वी आर एडिंग इट टू टाइम्स. सो बिकॉज वी आर एडिंग इट टू टाइम्स, तो दोनों में से हमें इसको एक बार सब्ट्रैक्ट करना पड़ेगा, सो दैट वी कैन गेट करेक्ट और एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू. दैट इज़ वाई आई हैव सब्ट्रैक्टेड नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज रिफ्लेक्सिव. ओके, एंड सेकेंड इज नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक, नाइदर सिमेट्रिक नॉर रिफ्लेक्सिव, यानी कि इसके बाहर वाला एरिया, यानी कि इसका कॉम्प्लीमेंट. इन दैट केस दिस इज कॉम्प्लीमेंट इज बेसिकली यूनिवर्सल सेट माइनस द यूनियन. सो कॉम्प्लीमेंट इसके अंदर आइदर यू कैन अप्लाई डिमॉर्गन्स लॉ ऑन दिस, आप इस पर डिमॉर्गन्स लॉ भी लगा सकते हैं, विच इज नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर नाइदर सिमेट्रिक इंटरसेक्शन नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर नॉर सिमेट्रिक. आप इस पर डिमॉर्गन्स लॉ भी लगा सकते हैं, और यू कैन सब्ट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सल सेट. दिस इज द यूनिवर्सल सेट, द टोटल नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस इज 2 पावर एन स्क्वायर माइनस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक यूनियन रिफ्लेक्सिव. ओके, क्लियर? Fine. Now, if it is clear with everyone, please answer this question. Number of relations which are irreflexive and symmetric. So, इस केस में भी please fill out all these values कि ऐसे कितने relations हैं which are irreflexive as well as symmetric होंगे, and number of relations which are reflexive or symmetric. Please answer all these questions again. So, this is about irreflexive. So, previous question was reflexive. तो इस क्वेश्चन में हम इररिफ्लेक्सिव की बात कर रहे हैं. प्लीज़ फिल आउट ऑल दिस वैल्यूज, टेक योर टाइम, फिल ऑल दिस वैल्यूज, फाइंड आउट द सॉल्यूशन. आई एम गिविंग यू 5 मिनट्स अगेन. तो आपके पास 5 मिनट है टू फाइंड आउट नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक, नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर इररिफ्लेक्सिव, नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज इररिफ्लेक्सिव, नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक और इररिफ्लेक्सिव, नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर नाइदर सिमेट्रिक नॉर इररिफ्लेक्सिव. सो यू हैव 5 मिनट्स टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, टेक योर टाइम. Fine. So almost the answers will be same as everyone said. Let me explain you the answers again. So number of relations, total number of relations, that is this universal set, this is 2 raised to power n square. Okay. Now the number of relations which are symmetric, they will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. So these are the number of relations which are symmetric. Okay. And the number of relations which are irreflexive, that is 2 raised to power n square minus n. We have already done this part. Okay. So I can write it this way. Total number of relations. Total number of relations. It will be 2 raised to power n square. Number of relations which are symmetric. That will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Number of relations which are irreflexive, that will be 2 raised to power n square minus n. Number of relations which are symmetric, intersection irreflexive. So the relations which are symmetric, intersection irreflexive. Okay. But here if you see, if a relation has to be irreflexive, then none of the diagonal element should be present. अगर किसी रिलेशन को इररिफ्लेक्सिव होना है तो उस केस में कोई भी डायगोनल एलिमेंट नहीं होना चाहिए. तो यानी कि हमारे पास किसी भी डायगोनल एलिमेंट के लिए कोई भी चॉइस नहीं है, नन ऑफ द डायगोनल एलिमेंट शुड बी प्रेजेंट. सो यू कैन सी फॉर डायगोनल एलिमेंट वी डोंट हैव अ चॉइस. ओके. एंड फॉर इररिफ्लेक्सिव इट डजंट रियली केयर अबाउट द नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स, बट फॉर सिमेट्रिक ऑल द नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट शुड कम इन अ पेयर. सो हियर इट विल बी 2 रेस्ट पावर एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई 2. सो फॉर सिमेट्रिक आइदर both the diagonal elements should be present. I mean, either the entire pair should be present or the entire pair should not be present. तो मैं इसको फिर से repeat करता हूँ. In case of irreflexive, आपके पास कोई भी diagonal element नहीं होना चाहिए. So they do not have a choice. Irreflexive में non-diagonal element के लिए कोई भी condition नहीं है. But symmetric में non-diagonal element के लिए कोई भी condition नहीं है. लेकिन non-diagonal के लिए condition है symmetric में कि वो pair में होना चाहिए. जैसे कि 2,1 है तो 1,2 भी होना चाहिए. तो या तो पूरा का पूरा पेयर हो या फिर कोई भी पेयर ना हो. तो हर एक पेयर के लिए आपके पास दो चॉइस है, विच इज 2 रेस पावर एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई 2. नाउ इफ आई आस्क नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक यूनियन इररिफ्लेक्सिव, दैट मीन नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक और इररिफ्लेक्सिव, दिस इज नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक प्लस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर इररिफ्लेक्सिव माइनस नंबर ऑफ रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक इंटरसेक्शन इररिफ्लेक्सिव. So this is equal to how much? This is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2 plus irreflexive ke liye 2 raised to power n square minus n minus symmetric union intersection irreflexive ke liye 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Okay. And again, number of relations which are neither symmetric nor irreflexive, this is basically universal set minus number of relations which are symmetric union irreflexive, so which is 2 raised to power n square minus number of relations which are symmetric union irreflexive. I hope this portion is clear to you. Do any one of you have any doubts with it? Kya kisi ko isme koi doubt hai? There are 15 people who are watching. Do any one of you have any doubt with it? Have a look at it and tell me. Fine, please write if you don't have any doubt. जल्दी से मुझे चैट विंडो के अंदर लिख दीजिए अगर आपको कोई भी डाउट नहीं है तो. एनीबडी इज हैविंग एनी डाउट प्लीज़ राइट अगेन क्विकली सो दैट वी कैन मूव फॉरवर्ड. सो दिस इज ट्रूथ एंड फॉल्स. प्लीज़ आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम ए टू एच. प्लीज़ आंसर ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस. इफ आर वन इज सिमेट्रिक देन एवरी सुपर सेट ऑफ आर वन इज सिमेट्रिक. इफ आर टू इज सिमेट्रिक देन एवरी सबसेट ऑफ आर टू इज सिमेट्रिक. If R1 and R2 are symmetric, then R1 intersection R2 is symmetric. If an R1 and R2 are symmetric, then R1 union R2 is symmetric. And R1 and R2 are symmetric, then R1 minus R2 is symmetric. please answer these questions. I need answers from each and every one of you. मुझे सभी से आंसर चाहिए बिकॉज पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ एवरी स्टूडेंट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. अगर आप पार्टिसिपेट नहीं करेंगे यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू लर्न. तो लर्न करने के लिए पार्टिसिपेशन बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी होता है क्लास के अंदर एंड इट इज़ बेटर टू हैव एन एक्टिव पार्टिसिपेशन. सो लेट मी टेल यू द आंसर्स. सो ऑप्शन नंबर ए, इफ आर वन इज सिमेट्रिक देन एवरी सुपर सेट ऑफ आर वन इज सिमेट्रिक. दिस इज फॉल्स. ऑप्शन नंबर ए इज फॉल्स. If R1 is symmetric, then every subset of R1 is symmetric. This is also false. If R1 and R2 are symmetric, then R1 intersection R2 is symmetric. That is true. If R1 and R2 are symmetric, then R1 union R2 is symmetric. That is also true. Subtraction is also symmetric. That is also true. This is also true. This is also true. This is also true. So first A and B are false, others are true. So most of you have given wrong answers because both of first A and B, both of them are false, others are true. So please ask your doubts. देखो, let us assume that we have a set A which is 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so we have a relation R1 and we say the relation R1 is symmetric. So it is having the values 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2. So you can clearly see that R1 is symmetric. If you take a subset of R1, so subset of R1, let us assume that subset is R2. And R2 subset is having the values 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 3. So you can clearly see that R2 is a subset of R1, but R2 is not symmetric. R2 जो है वो symmetric नहीं है, R2 जो है R1 का subset है. So you can see that every subset of a symmetric relation might not be symmetric. Second, if I take a superset of R1, so if I take a superset, so superset, let us assume that we have a superset which is R3. R3 is having the values 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, 3, 2, 1, 3. So we can clearly see that R1 is a subset of R3, R1 is a subset of R3, and R3 is not symmetric. So you can clearly see that every subset of a symmetric relation might not be symmetric, every superset of a symmetric relation might not be symmetric. So therefore first A and B both are false. Now if I take, let us assume we have a relation R4, and R4 is having the values 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Now you can clearly see that R4 is symmetric. So even if you take R1 intersection with R4, you are going to get a relation which is 1, 1 and 2, 2. So their intersection and this relation is also symmetric. So you can take any example whatsoever. So if R1 and R2 both are symmetric, if these both relations are symmetric, even if you take intersection, then you are only going to get a symmetric relation only. Okay. Next, if R1 and R2 are symmetric, then their union is also symmetric. Even if you find out the union of R1 and R4, so because R4 is also symmetric, R1 is also symmetric, even if you find the union, you will see that union is also symmetric. आप उनका union ले सकते हैं, आपको पता चलेगा union भी symmetric है. Again, set their difference. So even if you try to find out R1 minus R4, so R1 is also symmetric, R4 is also symmetric. Even if you do R1 minus R4, then again you are going to get a relation which is also symmetric. So you can clearly see if a relation is symmetric, then symmetric relations are closed under union, symmetric relations are closed under intersection, as well as symmetric relations are also closed under difference. Set difference ke case mein bhi symmetric relations hamare paas closed hai. So in only two cases, if you take a superset operation or subset operation, then symmetric relations are not then the relation might not be symmetric. Clear? Please write if you have any doubts. Good. Now read out these notes. Read them. This is just for your reference purpose only. I think you already know most of them, so you can figure out they are symmetric or not. So just have a just read them and ask me if you have any doubt with all of them, because I feel that you already understand all of them. Mujhe lagta hai aapko ye sabhi already understood honge. Agar kisi mein koi doubt hai to puch lijiye. Good. So the next kind of relation is anti-symmetric. So as I told, what is anti-symmetric? A relation R on a set A such that for all A comma B belong to the relation, if agar A comma B belong karta, if A comma B belong to the relation and B comma A also belong to the relation, then A should be equal to B. If it is the case, then we say that the relation is anti-symmetric. To us case mein hum bolenge the relation is anti-symmetric. Let me give you some examples. Assuming that we have a set A which is having the values 1, 2, 3. We have a relation R1 and R1 is having the values 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 3, 3, 1, 3, 3, 1. Now you can clearly see this relation R1, this relation is symmetric, but this relation is not anti-symmetric. So why it is not anti-symmetric is because agar 1, 2 exist karta hai and 2, 1 exist karta hai, yani ki that means if A comma B exist karta hai and B comma AB exist karta hai, in that case A should be equal to B. So here 1, 2 and 2, 1 exists, so 1 should be equal to 2, which is not the case. That is why it is not anti-symmetric. Okay, if I take the relation R2, which is 1, 2, 3, 3. So you can clearly see this relation is symmetric as well as this relation is also anti-symmetric. So this relation is aapka symmetric bhi hai, wo anti-symmetric bhi hai, as well as this relation is also reflexive. This relation is also reflexive, but this relation is not irreflexive. This relation is not irreflexive. So if you look at this relation, 1, 1 is there, 2, 2 is not there, 3, 3 is there. So this first relation is not reflexive, as well as first relation is also not irreflexive. Okay, so let me take the relation R3, which is having no values. It is an empty set. R3 is an empty set, or you can say phi. So here R3 is symmetric, R3 is also anti-symmetric, R3 is also irreflexive, but R3 is not reflexive. R3 jo relation hai wo symmetric bhi hai, anti-symmetric bhi hai, irreflexive bhi hai, but it is not reflexive. Then we have the relation R4. So R4 is having the values which is 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1. So clearly see, R4 is symmetric, R4 is not anti-symmetric, R4 is irreflexive, but R4 is not reflexive. Okay, if I take a relation R5, which is having the values 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3. Now this R5, this is symmetric, this is not anti-symmetric, this is not irreflexive, but yes, it is reflexive. Now did you understood what is anti-symmetric? So what do you mean by anti-symmetric? Anti-symmetric is if A comma B is there and B comma A is there, this can only be the case if A is equal to B. That means in case of anti-symmetric relations, diagonal elements should be there, and non-diagonal element in a pair, only one part should be there. In a non-diagonal element in a pair, only one part should be there, the entire pair should not be there. Okay, so did you understood what is this anti-symmetric? Any doubts in anti-symmetric, please ask. Have a look at it and tell me if you have any doubts in anti-symmetric. Chinu, I think you are not watching the video live. Aapka jo video hai wo kuch slow chal raha hai. You are a little bit behind. Please click on the live button on the video itself. To aapka jo video hai wo live chal jayega. I think you are not watching the video live. How R4 is not anti-symmetric? See, in case of R4, 1,2 is there and 2,1 also be there. So, agar for the relation, if the relation has to be anti-symmetric, then if 1,2 is there, then 2,1 should not be there. Agar 1,2 hai, to 2,1 nahi hona chahiye. Usi tarike se agar 1,3 hai, to 3,1 nahi hona chahiye. Because 1,2 aur 2,1 hai, this is the reason why the relation is anti-symmetric. Okay? So Ashi said 1,2, is this anti-symmetric? This is anti-symmetric. If 1,2 is there, that is anti-symmetric. So if we have a relation which is R6, which is having the values 1,2, 1,3, 2,3. Now this relation R6 here, R6 is not symmetric, R6 is anti-symmetric, R6 is not reflexive, R6 is irreflexive. So yahan par jo R6 relation hai, it is not symmetric, it is anti-symmetric, because 1,2 is there and 2,1 is not there. 1,3 is there, so 3,1 is not there. 2,3 is not there, so 3,2 is not there. So yahan par ye jo pair hai, pair mein se sirf ek hi element hona chahiye, plus aapka diagonal element ho sakte hain, there is no issues. Okay, is it clear? Any doubts? I don't think so, there is any doubt. Yes, Madhuri, in case of anti-symmetric, if A, B is there and B, is there, that means A and B should be equal. That means diagonal elements can be present, but non-diagonal element mein pairs mein se sirf ek hi element hona chahiye. Only one element should be there in the pair from non-diagonal elements. See, Devendra, you can clearly see that we have R2 is symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. Jo relation R2 hai, R2 symmetric bhi hai aur saath saath mein anti-symmetric bhi hai. R2 is symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. So we can have a relation which is symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. So R6, how R6 is anti-symmetric? See, R6 mein if we have 1,2 and 2,1 is not there, that is fine. Because anti-symmetric is only saying if A, B is there and B, A is also there. If A, B is there and B, A is also there, then A should be equal to B. But if A, B is there and B, A is not there, so that is no problem. Samajh rahe ho? Ki agar A, B hai, to B, A nahi ho, koi problem nahi hai. Lekin agar A, B hai aur B, A bhi hai, iska matlab hai A aur B equal hona chahiye. Theek hai? So in this case, R6, you have 1,2 and 2,1 is not there, so no issues. That is fit and fine. 1,3 is there but 3,1 is not there, so no issues. That is fit and fine. 2,3 is there but 3,2 is not there, so no issues. That is also fit and fine. So in case of R6, R6 here is anti-symmetric, it is irreflexive, but it is not symmetric. Okay, clear? I hope it is clear with everyone. So if it is clear, please answer this question. Jaldi se clear likh dijiye. Please write clear. Everyone please write clear in the chat window if it is clear. What do you mean by anti-symmetric? If it is clear with everyone, please write in the chat window. How R5 is not anti-symmetric? Because in case of R5, 1,2 and 2,1 is there. So this entire pair is there. That is why it is not anti-symmetric. Okay, good. It is clear with everyone. So let us move on to the next question. Please answer this question. What are the number of anti-symmetric relations possible? Let us assume that we have a set A which is having n elements. So if a set is having n elements, for that set, how many number of anti-symmetric relations are possible? किसी सेट के लिए कितने एंटीसिमेट्रिक रिलेशंस पॉसिबल है? प्लीज आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ एंटीसिमेट्रिक रिलेशंस आर पॉसिबल फॉर अ सेट विद एन एलिमेंट्स? सो लेट मी आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. In case of anti-symmetric relation, if A comma B is there and B comma A is also there, then A should be equal to B. That means in case of anti-symmetric relations, we can have diagonal elements. Diagonal elements do not have any issues, right? So these diagonal elements can be there. So every diagonal element is having a choice whether this element is present in the relation or this element might not be present. Whether this element is present in the relation or it might not be present. Whether this element is present or it might not be present. So yahan par jitne bhi aapke paas diagonal element hai, they have two choices. They have two choices that they might be present or they might not be present. Okay. And for the all the non-diagonal elements. तो आपके जितने भी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट है तो उसमें पेयर में से बस एक ही एलिमेंट होना चाहिए. जैसे कि हमारे पास 1,2 यहाँ पर है एंड 2,1 यहाँ पर है. सो फ्रॉम दिस एंटायर पेयर आइदर द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज प्रेजेंट और द सेकंड एलिमेंट इज प्रेजेंट और नन ऑफ द एलिमेंट इज प्रेजेंट. लेकिन दोनों एक साथ नहीं होना चाहिए. सो दिस पेयर इज हैविंग थ्री चॉइसेस. व्हाट आर द चॉइसेस? द फर्स्ट चॉइस इज आइदर द फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज प्रेजेंट और द सेकंड एलिमेंट is present or none of them. So it is having three choices. In the same way, 1,3, this is the pair 1,3. So for this entire pair we have three choices. Either the first element should be present or the second element should be present or none of them. So again it is also having 2,3 is also having a choice. Either the first element is present or the second element or none of them. So it is having three choices. So we can multiply all of them. How many choices we have? That is 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2. So if you calculate all of them, so it is 2 cube multiplied by 3 cube. So 2 cube is 8 multiplied by 3 cube is 20. So 3 cube is 27. So 8 multiplied by 27, these many number of symmetric relations are possible for this given set. तो इस सेट के लिए हमारे पास इतने सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन दीज मेनी नंबर ऑफ एंटी सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन आर पॉसिबल फॉर दिस सेट. यानी कि इस सेट के लिए हमारे पास 8 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 27 एंटी सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन हो सकते हैं. बट इफ यू ट्राई टू जनरलाइज इट, इफ लेट अस अज्यूम वी हैव अ सेट ए विच इज हैविंग टोटल ऑफ एन एलिमेंट. द सेट ए इज हैविंग कार्डिनलिटी एज एन. दैट मीन्स ए इज हैविंग द एलिमेंट्स विच आर 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 अप टू सो ऑन एन. इफ अ सेट ए इज हैविंग एन एलिमेंट, लेट अस राइट ए क्रॉस ए. हम ए क्रॉस ए के लिखते हैं. लेट अस राइट इट दिस मैनर दैट ए क्रॉस ए इज 1,1, 2,2, 3,3. सो आई हैव रिटन ऑल द डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स फर्स्ट. तो जितने भी डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स हैव रिटन इट हियर और जितने भी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स आई एम राइटिंग देम इन अ पेयर. सो 1,2, 2,1, 1,3, 3,1, 1,4, 4,1, up to so on. All these non-diagonal elements. So for these diagonal elements, how many diagonal elements will be there? There are total of n diagonal elements. How many non-diagonal elements are present? So number of non-diagonal elements are n square minus n. So n square minus n non-diagonal elements are present. Up in these diagonal element, for every element we have two choices whether this element is there or this element is not there. So aapke paas total n diagonal elements hain. So in sabhi n diagonal elements ke liye hamare paas 2^n choices हैं. अब जितने भी नॉन डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स यहाँ पर बचते हैं तो यहाँ पर हर एक पेयर के पास तीन चॉइस है. तो जैसे कि हाउ मेनी नंबर ऑफ पेयर्स विल बी देयर, सो नंबर ऑफ पेयर्स विल बी एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई 2. सो दिस इज 1,2 एंड 2,1 इज अ वन पेयर. 1,3 एंड 3,1 इज वन पेयर. सो देयर आर एन स्क्वायर माइनस एन डिवाइड बाई 2 पेयर्स. And for every pair we have three choices. हर एक pair के साथ तीन choices हैं. So number of choices for them is 3^n² - n/2. So if you see how many number of anti-symmetric relations are possible for a set with n elements, that is 2^n × 3^n² - n/2. कितने anti-symmetric relations possible है यहाँ पर? 2^n × 3^n² - n/2. I hope this part is clear with everyone. कोई doubt है तो please ask your doubt. If a set A is having n elements, so number of anti-symmetric relations possible on a set A with n elements is 2^n × 3^n² - n/2. Is it clear? जल्दी से चैट विंडो के अंदर क्लियर कर दीजिए, लिख दीजिए इफ इट इज क्लियर. प्लीज राइट क्लियर इफ इन द चैट विंडो इफ इट इज क्लियर. यू गाइज आर स्मार्ट, सुपर स्मार्ट, गुड. दर्पण इज देयर, गरिमा इज देयर, सब साक्षी इज मिसिंग टुडे. गरिमा, मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर मिसिंग, इवन साक्षी इज मिसिंग एंड वन मोर गाय इज ऑल्सो मिसिंग. सो वट इज द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज एंटी सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन. तो सिमेट्रिक और एंटी सिमेट्रिक रिलेशन के बीच में क्या रिलेशनशिप है. सो दिस इज जस्ट रिप्रेजेंटिंग अ वेन डायग्राम. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी वी कैन हैव सम रिलेशंस विच आर सिमेट्रिक एज वेल एज एंटी सिमेट्रिक, करेक्ट. सो लेट मी गिव एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर ऑल ऑफ देम. लेट मी फर्स्ट गिव एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस पार्ट. I mean the number of relations which are assume this is symmetric and this is representing anti-symmetric. So number of relations which are symmetric. तो ऐसे कितने relations हैं जो कि symmetric होंगे. So if let us suppose a set A is having n elements. So number of relations which are symmetric, they are 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. I think we have already done it, number of relations which are symmetric. Sorry, first I have answered this part. Number of relations which are symmetric, which is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Second is number of relations which are anti-symmetric. ऐसे कितने relation हैं जो कि anti-symmetric होंगे. So number of relations which are anti-symmetric, they are 2 raised to power n multiplied by 3 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. These many relations are there which are anti-symmetric, correct. And the total number of relations here, they are 2 raised to power n square. I can give examples for each of these reasons. Jaise ki, I have an example for symmetric. So symmetric ka ek example yahan pe likhta hu. The relation which is symmetric, we have R1 and the values are 1,1, 2,2, 3,3, 1,2, 2,1. So this is a relation which is symmetric. This relation is not anti-symmetric. For anti-symmetric, if we have a relation which is having values 1,2, 1,3, 2,3. So this relation here, this is anti-symmetric. R2 is anti-symmetric. So R1 is symmetric but not anti-symmetric. R2 is anti-symmetric but not symmetric. So the third one here is, if I take this part, so if I have the relation R3 which is having the values 1,1, 2,2, 3,3, so this relation R3 here, this is symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. Again see, R1 is symmetric but not anti-symmetric, R2 is anti-symmetric but not symmetric, and R3 is anti-symmetric as well as symmetric. So I've given examples for each of these reasons. मैं तीनों reasons के लिए हमारे पास example दिए हैं. Now we have to tell what are the relations possible which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. So it is clear, अगर कोई relation symmetric और anti-symmetric दोनों होगा, so in that case these diagonal elements will be there. I mean we have choice only for these diagonal elements because none of the non-diagonal elements should be present. So in case of the relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, so we have choices only for these diagonal elements. So the first diagonal element is having two choices, second is having two choices, third is having two choices. So there are n diagonal elements. So if you ask number of relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, they are 2 raised to power n. They are 2 raised to power n. So we have answered these questions. Number of relations which are symmetric, this is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Number of relations which are anti-symmetric, this is 2 raised to power n multiplied by 3 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Number of relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, this is 2 raised to power n. So if I ask you what is the number of relations which are symmetric or anti-symmetric, so this is number of relations which are symmetric plus number of relations which are anti-symmetric minus number of relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric. So this value will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised power n square minus n divided by 2 plus 2 raised power n multiplied by 3 raised power n square minus n divided by 2 minus 2 raised to power n. So these are the number of relations which are neither which are symmetric or anti-symmetric. I hope it is clear. So I guess I'm live now. So there is some issue because of network, because of rain. As I said, it started raining. So rain ki wajah se there is some issues. Please try and refresh your window. So I'll explain, no problem. First of all, please refresh your window. Again, there is issues because of internet network, because of rain. Rain ki wajah se there is some issue. That is why internet was not working. Let me explain you again. So number of relations which are symmetric, we already know. Number of relations which are anti-symmetric, we already know. Number of relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, we already know. So how we found this value is because if a relation has to be symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, that means only diagonal values, diagonal elements can be there. So diagonal elements, every element is having two choices and that n diagonal element. So there, every element is having two choices. So you can clearly see that there are n diagonal elements. So for all these diagonal elements, there are 2 raised to power n choices. So number of relations which are symmetric as well as anti-symmetric, that is 2 raised to power n. So if I ask you number of relations which are symmetric or anti-symmetric, that is number of relations which are symmetric plus number of relations which are anti-symmetric minus number of relations which are symmetric and intersection anti-symmetric. So symmetric will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 2 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. Anti-symmetric will be 2 raised to power n multiplied by 3 raised to power n square minus n divided by 2. And symmetric intersection anti-symmetric will be 2 raised to power n. So you can calculate these values and you will find out the relations which are symmetric or anti-symmetric. In the same way, you can also find out the relations which are not symmetric as well as not anti-symmetric. So that is a complement of this value, so which is universal set minus this value. You can easily find out that value, and that that's how you can get the answer. Is it clear with everyone? Kya sabhi ke sath clear hai? So symmetric and anti-symmetric, I think it is clear because upar sara portion clear hai, so ye bhi I think aapko clear ho hi jayega. So if it is clear, please solve this question. Next one is relationship between reflexive as well as anti-symmetric relations. Relationship between reflexive and anti-symmetric relations. It's raining here, I think internet band ho sakta hai. It's raining heavily. So it might happen that internet may go down at any time.